Hello students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Dr. Rajesh Gautam from Dr. Harishingaur Vishwavidyalaya Sagar, Madhya Pradesh. And today I am going to discuss with you a module entitled Marriage, Definition and Type from the paper Sociocultural Anthropology. So dear students, let I first tell you what we are going to discuss in this module. In this module, you will understand background of marriage, that is a major social institution, its definition and anthropological explanation. You will learn about the various types of marriages. I will also tell you the functions of marriage. Then you will also come to know the ways of acquiring mates. So let us start. When mating gets social approval and when it control the relations of a mated pair to each other, their kinship, their offspring and society at large, it will be known as marriage. Marriage is universal, that unites male and females in socially recognized reproductive significance beyond reproduction. Marriage is a fundamental cornerstone of human economic, social and units. Each culture provides rules which explicitly define which individual have access to which other. These explicit rules reduce conflict and anxiety and tend to channel sexual energy as well as legitimize childbearing. Marriage has been a central area of study since the beginning of anthropology as a main factor in explaining the variety of kinship system. The institution of marriage, however, has not been easy to define as an anthropological concept. But Beals and Hodger tried to define marriage as a set of cultural patterns to sanction parenthood and provide a suitable background for the care and rearing of the children. C.P. Kotak defines marriage as socially recognized relationship between a socially recognized male, that is husband, and a socially recognized female, that is wife, so that the children born to the wife are accepted as the offspring of both the husband and wife. From a descriptive point of view, it seems clear that when anthropologists refer to the institution of marriage, they designate a distinct class of phenomena. Yet, it is extremely difficult to define marriage as a concept useful in accounting for all the ethnographic cases. Cohabitation, sexual access, affiliation of children, food sharing and division of labor are very restricted criteria in accounting for the ethnographic spectrum. Let us examine a definition given in notes and queries. According to this definition, marriage is a ritual union between a man and woman such that the children born to the woman are considered as legitimate offspring of both the parents. The first element, that is heterosexual union, does not conform to such ethnographic phenomena as the traditional woman marriage among the Nuer or the homosexual marriage of postmodern societies.
even if the second element, legitimacy of offspring, apparently fits with the marriage customs of the matrilineal Nayars of South India. It might be rejected for its vagueness and its limited range of ethnographic cases. As another ethnographer, well, in 1997, notes the statement that marriage is required to produce legitimate children is finalist and tautological. According to the ethnographic data, marriage is neither necessary nor sufficient to define the legitimacy of children, as many societies recognize a sharp differentiation between social parenthood and marriage. In this direction, further, there are more definitions given by many scholars, and they tried to define marriage from different angle. Let we discuss it further.
In continuation, let me understand what Leach has defined marriage in 1961. According to Leach, marriage might be defined as a bundle of rights. Identified the following different rights, that is, legal fatherhood, legal motherhood, monopoly of sexual access between married partners, right to domestic services and other form of labor, right over property, acquiring to one's spouse, rights to a joint fund property for the benefit of the children of marriage, and recognized relations of affinity such as that between brother-in-law. But from this bundle of rights, no single right or set of rights must be defined as central to the universal definition of marriage. Today, marriage and family are universal. It exists among all kinds of societies. Similarly, all societies has parent-child social group, although the form and size of family may vary. At the same time, marriage is not always the basis for family life. One-parent family is becoming increasingly common in the developed societies. In such societies, more individuals are now choosing to have children without being married.
Ever from all contradictions, marriage is a socially approved sexual and economic union, usually between a woman and a man. The sexual marriage being granted social sanction is exceptional. It is presumed by both the couple and others to be more or less permanent, and it subsumes reciprocal rights and obligations between the two spouses and between spouses and their future children. Classical abolitionists have opinion that the marriage evolved from sexual promiscuity to group marriage, followed by polygamy, then monogamy came to existence. But when homosexual marriages are being granted social sanction, single parent family are increasing day by day, and children taking birth without marriage, again it is being proved that cultural evolution is taking place, and the form of marriage being changed day by day. Dear students, let now we understand types of marriage. Here you can visualize that there are two types of marriages. One is called monogamy and another is called polygamy. The monogamy can be further divided into serial monogamy and non-serial monogamy, whereas polygamy can be divided into polygyny, polyandry and synogamy or group marriage. And polygyny can be divided into sororal polygyny and non-sororal polygyny. Similarly, polyandry can be divided into fraternal polyandry and non-fraternal polyandry. Apart from the above mentioned type of marriages, there are some other forms of marriages defined in various societies. These are levirate marriage, which further divided as senior levirate and junior levirate marriage. Another is sororate, which is further divided into as senior sororate and junior sororate marriage. Then third is cross cousin marriages, and fourth is parallel marriage. Let now we try to understand each form of marriages. First is monogamy. It is a form of marriage when a single man marries a single woman or vice versa, and they settle down from a family. Mono means single and gamous means marriage. So in this way, in monogamy, there is union of one man and one woman. Among all forms of marriages, monogamy is most established and largely practiced all over the world. Monogamy is a response to the balanced sex ratio, as it also favors almost everyone a chance to have at least one spouse, and also it provides effective sexual gratification for women and men. It also facilitates relatively easy rules for inheritance, succession, and membership in kin group. Monogamy helps to maintain effective child rearing procedure, and augment close emotional ties between parents and children. Further, monogamy can be understood as, or it is divided into serial monogamy and non-serial monogamy. The serial monogamy is a sub-form of monogamy where a man gets married to another woman only after the death of the first wife. He can also go for third, fourth, fifth wife if the previous wife had died. In non-serial monogamy, man gets married to a woman and stays with each other till he or she dies. There is no provision for second marriage. Now let me come to know what is polygamy. It is a form of marriage when the marriage takes place between more than two individuals of opposite sex, then it is known as polygamy. Poly means many and gamous means marriage. It is then further categorized as polygyny, which is a subform of polygamy in which one man marries more than one woman at a time and stay together. Watermark was of the opinion that there were certain basic reasons for the origin or emergence of polygyny, that is enforced celibacy, earlier aging of females, desire for variety, the desire for more children, social prestige, and economic necessity. Polygyny is divided into serial or sororal polygyny, in which the co-wives or multiple wives of a man are sisters. This kind of polygyny can be seen among Gond and Kharia tribe and as well as some non-tribes also. In non-serial kind of polygyny, the co-wives or the multiple wives of a man are not necessarily sisters. Then the third kind of polygyny are called familial marriage. It is kind of polyandry practiced by some communities in Tibet, where the husbands of one wife are father and son. Now let me come to understand what is group marriage. Group marriage, also known as synogamy, is that type of marriage, is a type of marriage in which a group of men marry a group of women. This is one of the primitive kind of marriage. Each man of male group is considered to be the husband of every woman of the female group. Similarly, every woman is the wife of every man of the male group. This form of marriage is found among some tribes of New Guinea and Africa. In India, group marriage is practiced by the Toda tribe of Nilgiri Hills, but nowadays it is not common. It is obsolete practice, except on an experimental basis. It is an extremely rare occurrence and may never have existed as a viable form of marriage for any society in the world. Now, I will tell you about elaborate marriage. It is a type of marriage where a woman marries her deceased husband's brother. Further, levirate marriage is categorized as senior levirate, where the woman marries her deceased husband's elder brother, and junior levirate, where the woman marries her deceased husband's younger brother. In the similar way, there is sororate marriage. In this type of marriage, a man marries his deceased wife's sister. Like previous form of marriage, sororate marriage is also characterized as senior sororate, where the man marries his deceased wife's elder sister, and junior sororate, where the man marries his deceased wife's younger sister. Now let me discuss about cross-cousin marriage. It is the type of marriage where an individual is married to his or her cross-cousins. For example, individual getting married to mothers, brothers, son or daughter, individual getting married to fathers, sisters, son or daughter is called cross-cousin marriage. And this type of marriage is widely prevalent among many societies of today. Now, we will discuss about parallel cousin marriage. It is a type of marriage where an individual is married to his or her parallel cousin. For example, individual getting married to mother's, sister's, son or daughter, individual getting married to father's, brother's, son or daughter. This type of marriage is found in Kadar community. Functions of marriage. Anthropologists and sociologists have enlisted few of the aims of marriage. Those are as following. Marriage has the function to satisfaction of sexual need. Marriage fulfill the sexual need of the society as well as married couples. Procreation. This is also one of the functions of marriage, that it is essential for perpetuation and continuity of the species. Then third function of marriage is fulfillment of social and emotional economical needs. Marriage provides a definite division of labor among male and female, and in this way it fulfills social and economical needs. Fourth function of marriage can be stated as providing healthy environment for the growth and development of the children.
In continuation, I will tell you ways of acquiring mates. The tribes in India have variety of ways of acquiring mates, since the tribals consider their marriage more or less as a social and civil contract. The tribal marriages do not have absolute things like religious rituals and rites. They acquire mate by probationary marriage, marriage by capture, marriage by trial, marriage by purchase, marriage by service, marriage by exchange, marriage by elopement, marriage by intuition, and inheritance of widows, proposed or arranged marriage. So let me discuss each of these ways of acquiring mates one by one. First, we will discuss about probationary marriage, what it is. In this type of marriage, a tribal youth lives in the house of his sweetheart for weeks or months together. Thereafter, if both of the boys and girls like each other, they may enter into wedlock, or in case of dislike, they may be separated. If marriage is not solemnized, the boy will have to pay compensation to the girl's parents. It is called as probationary marriage because the boy stays in his would-be father-in-law's house as a probationer. The Kuki tribe of Arunachal Pradesh are said to follow this type of marriage. Similarly, there are some tribes in central India like Gaur and Baga. They also practice this kind of marriage. Marriage by capture. This is the another way of acquiring mates among tribes. This is a popular type of marriage among several Indian tribes. It can be both ceremonial and forceful or by physical power. The boy and girl like each other, but due to restrictions from the parent and the community and inability to pay bride price, the capture takes place. Sometimes the physical captures are pre-arranged and often take place in fair, festivals, market, and sometimes in ceremonial captures. The boy simply smear vermilion on the girl's forehead. This type of marriage is practiced among the Khond, Juang, Bhuiya, Khariya, Birhor, etc. The Nagas take recourse to physical capture during raids from one village to another.
In continuation of understanding the various way of acquiring mates, now let me come to know marriage by trial. This is a peculiar type of marriage practiced among Bhils. In this type of marriage, the courage and bravery of the young man is appreciated and recognized in assigned competition. If a boy comes out successful in his endeavor, he is free to choose any girl from the group for marriage. Marriage by purchase. In this form of marriage, the man pay the price for the bride in the form of bride price to the girl's parents before he has her as his wife. The price paid may be in the form of cash or coin. This type of marriage is widely prevalent among a number of tribes all over India. The price is paid by the groom's father to the girl's father. According to the traditional custom, this type of marriage is found among the Khond, Juang, Ho and Munda. The Rangma Nagas also practice this way of acquiring mates. Marriage by service. Some tribals have evolved the solution of higher bride price, which the economically weaker tribal youths are not able to afford the bride price, and hence this form of marriage came into existence. If the bridegroom is unable to pay the bride price, he has to service in his would-be father-in-law's house as a servant and marry the girl after the lapse of a specific period. During the period, the boy works in the house of the would-be father-in-law without any payment and equalize the bride price by providing his free services. Gaur and Baga practice this type of marriage and it is called Lamsena. Marriage by exchange. If a son and daughter of marriageable age are available in two families, they may exchange the daughters and do not pay any bride price for obtaining the bride. In tribal India, Kondh, Shaura, Chuang, Bhunya, Santhal, etc. practice this type of marriage. Marriage by elopement. Among many Indian tribes, the unmarried boys and girls stay in dormitory and are often involved in sexual relationship by coming in contact with each other. If the parents do not give consent to the love of the boy and the girl for marriage, then they flee away to some other place without any information to the parents. Such delinquent couple may later on be received back by their parents. In this type of marriage, bride price is easily avoided. Juang, Santhal, Bhunya, Kondh and Shaura practice this type of marriage. Marriage by elopement was also practiced by some of the Himalayan tribes like Kinnora. Marriage by intrusion. This is the reverse way of marriage by capture, where in a girl desirous of marrying a particular male expressed her willingness and goes to his house to stay. She forcibly thrust herself onto him and stays with him despite the non-acceptance of the male and his family. In the process, she is subjected to humiliating treatment and refusal of food and often physical torture. But in spite of such humiliation, disrespect or torture, if she sticks to the marriage and stays there, she is accepted and the marriage is performed. Such kind of marriage is widely practiced among Juang, Kondh, Bhunya and some other tribes. But such marriage are also reported from Birhaur and Ho tribes of Chota Nagpur region. Proposed or arranged marriage or marriage by negotiation. When the parents of both the boys and girls come forward to negotiate their children's marriage, it is known as marriage by negotiation or proposed or arranged marriage. It is a regular form of marriage being practiced widely in Indian society.
So, dear students, now let's summarize what you have learned in this module. You know, marriage is an universal institution. There are various types of marriages, but mating is predominantly a psychophysical phenomenon involving the pairing of individuals of opposite sex under the influence of sexual drive. Marriage is something else when mating gets social approval and when it controls the relation of a mated pair to each other, their kinsmen, their offspring and society at large. It is known as marriage. There are several definitions given by different scholars, anthropologists, sociologists and some other thinkers, but some of the definitions given for marriage is by Wiles and Hauser, C.K. Katak, Leach and some others. They have defined marriage in different way and they tried to establish that marriage is a union, socially, legally accepted union between male and female with certain purposes. Type of marriage recognized under anthropology are various. There are monogamy, polygamy, there are type of monogamy, type of polygamy. Then in this module, we also discussed about functions of marriage. The marriage has evolved as an institution with a purpose. It has definite functions, and if the function of marriage will not fulfill, this institution will gradually lost, or this institution bit will gradually vanish. Then we also discussed about ways of acquiring mates among the tribal societies. Thank you.